2 weeks from today is Election Day, and we're seeing a steady flow of voters so far. Joining me now to discuss Decision 2016 is Secretary of State John Husted. Thanks for being here.
Great to be with you.
And we'll start off talking about early voting. What are we seeing so far here in Ohio?
Well, early voting numbers started out strong, but they have since fallen behind. Even though early voting has been more popular in the last few election cycles, we've actually had fewer requests for absentee ballots this time than in the 2012 general election. At this point in the 2012 general election, we had 1.6 million ballots that were requested. We're at 1.42 million at this point in time. So voters seem less interested this year than they did 4 years ago.
Which is surprising because there's so much, it's so highly publicized, and social media, it just seems like so many people are talking about this election. Do you think those voters will come out maybe November 8th?
Well, I don't think so, and this is why. This is the first presidential election we ever had where we had a candidate running for president who had a net negative approval rating. But we not only have one, we have two. Both of the leading candidates are deemed as unfavorable choices by the majority of voters in our state, and I think that is really softening voter interest in this election, and that's of concern.
So you think overall voting numbers will be down this election?
We have every reason to indicate that it should be, even though typically when you have a presidential election that has two candidates that are new, it doesn't involve an incumbent, you usually see in those elections higher voter turnout, but all the evidence we have so far says lower. And the sad thing about that is that there's a lot more to care about than just the presidential candidates. There are U.S. Senate races, congressional races, state legislative races, local races, county officials, and levies. There are over 1,800 levies on the ballot that could change your schools, your police and fire protection, your tax rates. Lots of reasons to go out and vote other than just the people at the top of the ticket.
And how would you compare and contrast 2012 and 2008, the voter turnout in those years, those election years, to now?
Well, 2008 was essentially a record level. That was the open election between Barack Obama and John McCain. And that was a record turnout. 4 years later, in 2012, it was still a pretty high turnout in that re-election of President Obama, but this time we're just not seeing it.
And then, you know, Donald Trump has been out there saying polls are rigged. Even today he told a group of reporters to ask President Obama about rigged elections. What would your reaction and response be to that?
Well, I think it's an irresponsible thing to say. Elections are not rigged in America. They're certainly not rigged in Ohio. I'm not going to suggest that voter fraud never happens. Of course it happens. But it's rare, and we hold people accountable. It's a fifth-degree felony in the state of Ohio, so we've prosecuted and sent people to prison for a voter impersonation, casting multiple ballots, but it doesn't happen. We're talking hundreds of cases in the state of Ohio since I've been Secretary of State. It's not widespread. So to suggest that it's rigged is not a responsible thing to say. And remember how this works. At the polls on Election Day, those people checking IDs, well, they're your friends and neighbors. They're people that live in your community. On election night, when we count the votes, that's an open public process. The media is allowed to be there. The public can observe. And you'll have Democrats and Republicans all there from the Board of Elections. Our Board of Elections are bipartisan in the state, making sure that there's no conspiracy, that there's no rigging, that it's an open, transparent process. We allow observers at the polls if you're properly trained and following the rules. So we believe that the transparent, open process in Ohio should build people's confidence. And the good news is after I spoke out about this, when Donald Trump was in Ohio last week, he said that he had confidence in Ohio's elections, that he thought that Ohio was doing a good job. He wasn't worried about the elections here, just in other states. So at least Ohio has that going for us.
All right, well, thank you so much. Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
Hopefully, more people will come out and vote. Well, thanks for being here.
Thanks.